Today we learned that Roger Stone, President Trump's longtime confidant, has been charged with instructing a witness in the Mueller investigation to, quote, pull a Frank Pantangeli, which, as you see, means to lie. Stone's been a fixture in Republican politics for more than four decades, including a stint on the Trump campaign, but now his sleazy, take-no-prisoners approach might actually land him in the slammer.
I'm Roger Stone, R-O-G-E-R-S-T-O-N-E.
He's been called a dirty trickster, the Prince of Darkness, even the cockroach of American politics by the left-leaning New Republic. And Roger Stone flaunts many of these monikers as proudly as he flaunts his Nixon back tattoo.
I'm an agent provocateur.
Stone's reputation is hard-earned. His notorious political rap sheet goes back to the Nixon campaign when the then 19-year-old donated money to Nixon's opponent. He said it was from the Young Socialist Alliance and gave the receipt to the press. It didn't get any more ethical from there. In 1980, Stone began a lobbying firm with Paul Manafort that unapologetically catered to human rights abusers. Stone once boasted they, quote, lined up most of the dictators in the world that we could find. Pro-Western dictators, of course, the good ones. Nevertheless, the questionable consultant's resume is filled with work for Republican stars. Nixon, Reagan, Bush Sr., and of course...
I'm a political advisor to Donald Trump.
While working for Bob Dole, Stone's personal life caused a public stir. He was forced to resign from Dole's presidential campaign after a tabloid revealed that he and his wife had placed an ad for a sex partner in a paper called Local Swing Fever. But Stone did not go away. He continued to stir the political pot.
Fair trade agreement. So that
in 1999, Stone helped Donald Trump navigate his first short-lived campaign for the presidency.
I've got to give my best advice, but Mr. Trump makes the decisions. And frankly, the polls so far kind of reflect that voters like it.
A year later, in 2000, Stone took credit for disrupting the Florida recount by organizing a Republican riot at the Miami-Dade Elections Office. All the while, the Stone list of dirty tricks and black ops continued to grow. Stone took credit for the downfall of then-New York Governor Eliot Spitzer, saying he found out about Spitzer's penchant for prostitutes from a sex worker he met at a Miami swingers club.
Welcome to the Stone Zone.
Through his online channel, The Stone Zone, and national TV appearances, Stone has for years peddled countless deranged conspiracy theories.
I am not a conspiracy theorist. I'm a conspiracy realist.
And through all of this, there has been a mainstay, his longtime friend Donald Trump, who reportedly continued confiding in Stone even after firing him from his campaign in 2015. Stone claims he quit.
We go back a very long time. I have, Donald Trump came to my wedding. I went to two of his. I was at both his parents' funerals. I have great affection for Trump and the Trump family.
So what advice might the president have received? One passage from Stone's book of life lessons stands out. Quote, admit nothing, deny everything, launch counterattack.
So take a listen to Roger Stone today.
The only thing worse than being talked about.
The only thing worse than being talked about is not being talked about. He's being talked about because he was indicted.
Jake, he's looking like a mini Nixon there. The only thing he didn't say is, I am not a crook directly. And it's really not a good look. I mean, there have been 34 people charged, three companies, almost 100, you know. It's something wrong with this man. And it's something wrong with all of the president's men, it seems like, that this entire, I mean, he has been, the president, I want people to wrap their minds around this. President Trump has been under some type of investigation ever since he took office.
Yep.
Imagine that.
So President Trump tweeted in December about Roger Stone, Kevin, take a listen to this, or take a look at this. I will never testify against Trump, that's President Trump quoting Stone. This statement was recently made by Roger Stone, essentially stating that he will not be forced by a rogue and out-of-control prosecutor to make up lies and stories about, quote, President Trump. Nice to know that some people still have, quote, guts. That does seem to be paramount to President Trump, more than anything else, loyalty to him.
Yeah, and he is the personification of the Trump approach to politics, too, right? Which is, forget it, it's not so much about ideas, but whatever you do, and Brian Stelter quoted this earlier, whatever you do, don't be boring, right? Mm-hmm. And that's... Donald Trump's approach to politics, it's the same thing with Roger Stone. I think the bet here, it'll be interesting to see whether or not it's the right bet. The bet here that Roger Stone is making is that this can be won in the court of public opinion. The special counsel is making the bet that this is going to be won in the court of law and that that ultimately is what will win the day. We're going to have to see that play out over the next few months.
I think Roger Stone is making the bet that he will be pardoned by Donald Trump.
Yeah,
you think
exactly.
That is?
That's it. And with public opinion from Donald Trump's base.
I see, for the base. So, yeah. And the indictment makes some incredible allegations against Stone. I should say they're not the allegations. There's evidence of them, including he threatened to kill the dog of person number two in the indictment, Randy Credico. He tells Credico, quote, "You are a rat, a stoolie. You backstab your friends, run your mouth. My lawyers are dying to rip you to shreds. I am so ready. Let's get it on. Prepare to die." And then there's also some stuff about his dog. Let's show a picture of the dog because I just want to show it.
And he's a sweet little
dog.
And he complained about the FBI raid waking up his dog. So we know, if anything, that they're dog people.
I mean, the truth is no one's going to cry if Roger Stone goes to jail or when he goes to jail. Mm-hmm. But
he might like it.
But he might. Who knows? But the real question is given all of their history here between Trump and Roger Stone, is it actually plausible he didn't know what he was up to?
That's right.
What did Trump know? When did he know it? We don't know it yet, but I'm sure we'll learn it.
That's why the court of law is much bigger than the court of public
opinion. Can I also just say, like, it's pretty remarkable that the president of the United States has a close associate like Roger Stone. I mean, there are dirty tricksters in every party and every, you know, every corner of politics, but this is a close friend of President Trump's, and this guy's awful.
Birds of a feather.
Has a Nixon tattoo.
Yeah.
That's a big red flag right there.
All right.
Well, I think that's unfair to Nixon, really.
Okay,
no, I just want to say.